In part two of the ETLook algorithm, we will be looking at what ET means and what does it say about your crop and soil. The ETLook algorithm provides evapotranspiration data, which can be used to analyze crops, support management decisions, and audit quantities of water used. In part one, we explained the methodology behind the ETLook algorithm. Part two looks at the output and how evapotranspiration data can be of support for your farm management practices. Let's start with the basic terminology to distinguish between evaporation, transpiration, and evapotranspiration. Evaporation, or E, is liquid water changing into gas on a surface. On a warm day, bare soil loses water due to evaporation into the air relatively easily. And in this picture, we can see the result of bare soil that has lost too much water due to evaporation. Secondly, transpiration, or T, is the process of water movement through the plant and leaving through the leaves. Plants absorb water in a liquid state through the roots, water then travels up through the plant, and water vapor is lost from leaf pores in transpiration. Evaporation and transpiration are often mentioned together and are given one value. This is evapotranspiration, or ET. To summarize, evapotranspiration is the sum of the amount of water that is evaporated from the soil and the amount of water that is lost through transpiration by the crop, cover crop, and or weeds. When we look at the water cycle, non-consumed water can be recaptured for downstream use or can replenish groundwater. Water consumed by evapotranspiration cannot. It represents the actual amount of water lost in the crop production process and is expressed in millimeters per week. The water lost by evapotranspiration is picked up in the water cycle and can come back via precipitation. FruitLook provides you with the actual evapotranspiration information. This is the real crop water use on a certain day and what the ETLook algorithm calculates. The potential evapotranspiration represents the amount of water that could be evaporated and transpired under actual meteorological conditions and ample water supply. This means no stress and optimal water availability. The difference between the actual and potential is the evapotranspiration deficit. The deficit is the amount of millimeters the crop would have liked additionally in order to have no stress. The image shows for the clicked point 4.44 millimeters per week of evapotranspiration deficit. This is just an extra layer of information. For many crops, a bit of stress is a good thing and supports growth of fruits. For others, it is critical. We will tell you a bit more on how to use FruitLook's evapotranspiration data for irrigation management in the next video. But when applying irrigation, take into account possible losses, depending on your soil and irrigation method. Also remember to look at the weather forecast. For example, if rain is predicted, you won't need to irrigate. Please do contact us if you have any questions on the ETLook algorithm or any other aspect of FruitLook.